Hello my dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. In today's video lecture, we are going to learn the concept percentage in the chapter 7, ratio, proportion and percentage. These two concepts we have already learned, ratio and proportion, okay. The last one, third one concept today we are going to learn, that is percentage, okay. So see, on the blackboard, I have written some sentences. These sentences we often hear or read or see in the market or hear on the television advertisement, right? Okay, so let us read these sentences. See, the first sentence is 5% discount on each dress. 5% discount on each dress. Second sentence is 10% cashback offer. 10% cashback offer on Amazon sale. In each 1 kilogram packet of tea, get 20% more. Get 20% more. Aryan got 89% marks in annual exam. So in these sentences or such sentences we frequently hear, see in the banner, on the banner of, in the market, right, or in the advertisement of any product, okay, we often see these sentences, or when you get the scorecard of your exam, you see your marks, I got 89%, I got 95% and so, okay, so if you see this, here 5%, 10%, here 20% or 89%, okay. If you see these numbers with this sign, it is read as 5%, 10%, 20%, 89%. What is mean by this actually? What is mean by percent? 5%. See, discount on each dress is 5%. So what is exactly discount? 5% means how much exactly in number? Suppose you have purchased dress of rupees 1000, right? Dress of rupees 1000, then there is discount of 5%. So exactly how much discount you will get? Means how much rupees you have to give less in 1000? 5% discount is how much exactly? Or see, 10% cashback offer on Amazon sale. Suppose you have purchased on Amazon, you have purchased the things worth rupees 25,000, for example. Then 10% cashback is there. Okay, so you will get 10% cash back. That is 10% means how much exactly? 10% means how much or how many rupees exactly? Is it 10 rupees? 10% means 10 rupees. You have purchased things worth rupees 25,000. So 10% cashback means you will get 10 rupees back. What is 10% means exactly? Okay. In each 1 kg packet of tea, get 20% more. 20% more tea you will get on each packet of, in each packet of tea. So 20% more means exactly how many gram tea you will get extra. 20% means exactly how many gram tea you will get extra. Aryan got 89% marks in the annual exam. 89% marks means Aryan got 89 marks. In all 6 papers he got 89 marks. What is 89% means exactly? Okay, so this, all these things which we see, which we read or which we see, that we are going to learn in this concept percentage, percentage, okay. So now one thing you have come to know, that this symbol, this slash and these two circles, this symbol is used to represent percent, okay, percentage, okay. So percent means what? That we see. So you know that this symbol is used to represent percentage, okay. Now here see the word percent. Percent or percentage, same, okay. So this word I am going to divide into two parts, this way. Per same. So see, in many word problems we have seen that cost of sugar per kg, cost of sugar per kg means per 1 kg, correct? Per 1 kg. Similarly, here see, per cent. Per cent, you know, cent means what? Cent means century. Cent means century. Century means 100, okay? Century means 100. Per means per 100. Understand? Per cent means per 100. So, whenever we say there is 5% discount, there is 5% discount means 5 per 100 means if you have purchased dress worth rupees 100, cost rupees 100, then you will get rupees 5 discount on 100. So, if you will get 5% discount then, 5 rupees discount then, cost will be 95. But if you have purchased product of rupees 1000, if you have purchased dress of rupees 1000 and there is 5% discount, then you will get 5 rupees only discount for this 1000. No, for 100 there is 5% means for 100 5, for 100 5 rupees discount. Then for 1000 how much or how many rupees discount you will get? Not 5, okay? 5%, 5 per 100. So for 1000 we have to count exactly how much discount you will get for 1000 rupees, okay? Offer is 5% discount means for every 100 5 rupees less. So if you see in this 1000, how many hundreds are there? In 1000 how many hundreds are there? 10 hundreds are there, okay? So for every 100 5 rupees discount. So for 10 hundreds, 10 fives are 50. You will get 50 rupees discount for 1000 rupees. So that dress it will be cost for 950 rupees. Okay? So that how to count that percentage we will see later. Just understand the concept. Per cent means per 100. 5% means 5 rupees discount for every 100. Okay? Then there was 10% cashback. 10% cashback means for every 100 you will get 10 rupees back. Suppose you have purchased product of rupees 500, then how many rupees you will get back for every 100? 10 rupees. 10%. Then for 500 you will get 10 fives are 50 rupees back. Okay, for 1000 rupees you will get 10 are 100 rupees back. Okay, so this is meaning of percent. 10% means 10 per every 100. Okay, so this can be written as this. See this 5%. So 5% can be written as this way: 5 out of 100. Or 10% means 10 out of 100. I got 89% marks. I got 89% marks means I got 89 out of 100. I got 89 out of 100. That means 89%. There was 20% extra. 20% extra means 20 per 100. Okay? So this is meaning of the percentage. 5% means 5 out of 100, 20% means 20 out of 100, 10% means 10 out of 100, 89% means 89 out of 100. Understand? This is the concept of percentage. Now, basically in this chapter or in this class, we are going to learn the conversion of percentage into fraction and conversion of fraction into percentage or conversion of decimal into percentage. Okay? As we have seen here, 5% means nothing but 5 out of 100. So this was 5%, it was given in percentage. We converted that into fraction, 5 upon 100. 5 out of 100, so this is fraction. 10%. 10% means what? 10 out of 100. Correct? 10% means 10 out of 100. So here, this 10 was given in percentage. We converted that into fraction. 89% means what? 89 upon 100. See, this is in percentage that we have converted into fraction. 89 is numerator, denominator is 100. So another way we can say that percentage means when denominator is 100, that fraction can be expressed as a percentage. When denominator is 100, see, when denominator of any fraction is 100, that in that fractions the numerator is expressed as a percentage. Okay, means see, in this 5 upon 100, denominator is 100, numerator is 5, so how many percentage? 5%. In this fraction, denominator is 100 and numerator is 10, so this numerator can be expressed as a percentage, 10%. 89 upon 100, denominator is 100, so the numerator 89 can be expressed as a percentage. Understand? Percentage means such fractions whose denominator is 100. Okay? So, in this way we can convert percentage into fractions and fractions into percentage. Okay? Now see. Let us solve now practice 7.3, in which we will convert fractions into percentage or percentage into fractions. It's very easy. Once you have understood the concept, if you don't understand, watch it again. So when we solve examples in practice 7.3, we will come to know how to convert fractions into percentage and percentage into fractions. Okay? Okay, see this first question in practice 7.3. Convert the given fractions into percentage. See, in this practice 7.3, first two questions are given in tabular form. Tables are given in the textbook. We have to solve in the textbook itself. Open your page number 129. Okay, first table, see, convert the given fractions into decimal, and first one example already they have shown in the textbook, even though I will explain you again. Okay, now these are fractions and we have to convert into percentage. Fractions we have to convert into percent. Okay, understand? Now see, we know that when fraction can be expressed as a percentage, yes, when its denominator will be 100. So what we have to do here? Just we have to convert the denominator into 100. Once we get denominator 100, so when we convert denominator 100, accordingly numerator will also change. Okay, so once we will get denominator 100, its numerator we will express in the percentage. Okay, so see here, the given fraction is 1/2. Now here denominator is 2. To convert this denominator 2 into 100, by which number we need to multiply 2? 2 multiplied by how many we get 100? 2 multiplied by 50. 50 twos are 100. So let us multiply 2 denominator by 50. So now according to the rule of fraction, when we multiply any numerator or denominator by any number, if you multiply denominator by any number, by same number, we need to multiply in the numerator also. This is the rule of fraction which we have learned in the chapter fraction. Okay. Now see, 52s are 100 we got, and 51s are 50. So now, same fraction 1/2 we have converted into its equivalent, such equivalent fraction whose denominator is 100. Okay. Now we have got denominator 100, 50 out of 100. That means what? Now this numerator can be expressed as a fraction, percentage. Okay, 50%. Understand? This directly this one cannot be expressed as a percent because there is denominator is not 100 there. We converted that into 100. At that time numerator got 50. So 50 is expressed as a percent. Okay. Next. 3 upon 4. Now here denominator is 4. To convert 4 into 100, 4 multiplied by how many you will get 100? 4 into 25, or 25 fours are 100, correct? So we need to multiply by 25. So in the numerator also we need to multiply by 25. Okay. Now 25 fours are 100. Then what is 25 threes are? 25 threes are 75. Okay. So 75 out of 100 means 75%. Okay. Next. 2 upon 5. Denominator is 5. 5 multiplied by how many 100? 25 is 100. 25 is 100. So multiply by 20. So here also multiply by 20. 22 is 40 and 25 is 100. So 40 out of 100. That means how many percent? 40%. Okay. 6 upon 10. Denominator is 10. 10 multiplied by how many 100? 12 multiplied by how many? You will get 100. 10 tens are 100. So 60 tens are. 6 tens are. Okay. So here we got 100 as a denominator and 10 6 are 60. So 60 out of 100. 60 upon 100 means 60%. Okay. So in this way any fraction can be converted into percentage. Just what we have to do? We have to make its denominator 100. Okay. Now pause this video. Write these examples in your notebook. Remaining part of this practice 7.3 we will see in the next lecture. So thank you for today and have a nice day.